This tape will document the birth and hopefully growth of my bass selling business. This particular instrument is my prize of my collection, which is all of about three basses now. It's a 1976 Stingray, one of the first couple months of production. This is where the business is housed right now. It's also my basement. This is some inventory here that I just leave out to kind of play with. Some Stingrays, some G&Ls, graphite there. There's a little Fender there. Mustang bass. I store my instruments in my storeroom. Hopefully this will be the first of many storerooms that will be increasing in size. I presently inventory about 20 basses, in case I didn't get the date on here. It is December 12th. I started about a year ago, actually. Do most of my work here on my PC. That's a new ad that I'm working on to put in the Bass Player magazine. And I enter names into my mailing list here. Okay, hang on. All right, I'm recording. I've got Daryl Jones, who used to be a big Wheeler dealer in basses. He's retired. And I'm, this is the 1,000th person on my mailing list. His name is Ben. Well, you can read it there on the screen. As you can see, 1,000. Okay. No, Daryl, I'm not sending him anything free. Signing off. Okay, from time to time on this tape, I'm going to take some photos of some instruments that are extraordinary for some reason. This one is a 79 Stingray with a narrow neck. That's extraordinary about it, I guess. I haven't seen too many of these. 1.5 inches of the nut. The rest of it's just pretty standard Stingray fare. Let's see if you can see if I can focus in on this. The light isn't great. It's in pretty good shape. This particular guy liked to have a patch cord back here that did some nice damage, but besides that, overall it's pretty good. Okay, this is a USA Spectre MS-2 fretless. The reason this one is extraordinary, well, it's a beautiful piece, but according to Stuart Spectre, they only made about 20 stock fretless. USA, I guess. This is a very good sounding fretless. That's where I was looking. I'm missing a knob on the bottom corner. That knob gets crunched in a little bit. You see the back of it. Not the glare. Still one crew. I think they made about 2,500 Spectres altogether. I don't normally do this, but this thing sounded so good, I just wanted to get it on tape. First of all, the black one is probably the earliest L2000 that I will ever see. It's, I can get the serial number in there. Yeah, B001511. This one is one of the earliest fretless, but definitely the earliest that I've seen to date, with an ebony fingerboard. And again, the big headstock. Okay, we're gonna crack the neck on this one. Okay, today we're just gonna look at a couple interesting pieces I have. This is a 1985 Stingray with binding. They only made about 15 of these. If I can get a good shot of this. They actually were able to follow the contour on this one. Made these for the NAMM show. White pickup is also not the usual. Appears to be a maple body. It's real heavy. See the headstock. See that? It's like a transition logo, because then we'll go over and take a look at what a new Ernie Ball looks like. That's what the new ones look like. You can see they match the piece of maple right down the center. It's a nice piece of wood, just a little too heavy, but it is a cool base. This is the first Moses graphite fretless neck I've had, or they've made probably actually. There's an overhang, a couple extra frets. That headstock will not be the one they're in production on. This is a older Stingray body. Someone smart enough to put a shell or bridge on, fill the holes, all that kind of stuff. It's actually a very nice base though, just the way it is. And take a look at the back of the neck. Very nice plain base. I think I'm going to put it down. This is the first mention I'll make, but on this tape you'll see more about it. This week we've gone to work on a prototype base. Don't know really what'll come of it. But our repairman and I, Hugh, have been working on trying to combine the best qualities of both these bases onto one base. Stingray and a jazz base. J-Ray, I don't know what that would call it. But we'll see what happens. And one other thing, a new addition to the company, is a paper folding machine. It'll save hours of paper folding misery. Off for now. Okay, see that base? Thanks to Pino Palladino. And then that base. So that's why I'm taking a picture of this one. The original Rosewood fingerboard fretless. Pretty rare bird. You can see it's in excellent condition. Let me see if I can get a better angle of it. Very nice piece. I'm sure Fred's Fair Street Music will be very happy with it. Back is almost as clean as the front. Very nice piece. This is a preliminary drawing of the base Hugh and I are working on. Hopefully you'll see a lot more about this later on in the tape. We've actually got a body cut for it, waiting for electronics. This drawing was done by a friend of mine named Ian Smith. Pretty good artist. No names yet. Hopefully have one ready within about 3 or 4 weeks. Hopefully by, actually, February 27th. Guitar show. This one I'm filming is my booth this year, Janelle's, Modulus. Whoa. Flock of stingrays. We've just had an upgrade. Low D Productions has brought in a truckload. We got an old Hofner. Hey, what year is the Hofner? Both 1964 Hofners. Ken Smith. What else? A Sadowski. And my new Stingray 5. And Daryl, say hi.
Hello, Cheryl.
I'm not making it safe for Cheryl, you bonehead. I'm making
Hello,
it for
Cheryl.
Myself.
I know
this is John.
Boss. Hi, Dan.
John's from down where we want to move to.
Beautiful country.
That's right. You live in Paducah?
No, I still live up by Carbondale.
All right, so you commute to Paducah.
Yeah.
All right, signing off, because Daryl always has something interesting to say.
That's right.
Getting real dull.
Say it.
Me. Big deal, Mr. Light Guy. This is George. Takes some pretty nice pictures. He's gonna make my guitar a star.
Oh, it's already a star. All we're gonna do is publicize it.
There's Daryl again. Again, he's got nothing to say, so This is Fred's Fair Street Music. This is where the big boys come to play.
That's right.
Let's see what he's got on display here. Boy, I can't see anything here that I like. No.
Get out of our booth. Get out of here.
Blackface here. Fred's always working hard at these shows. You can see now he's out there hustling all the time. We call him the Scott Silver of Southern Illinois. Very good. The folks from Crossroads working hard and hardly working. Let's see this.
There he goes. The branch.
Hey, there he goes. There he goes. There he goes. This is Guitar Ranch. Finest vintage guitars in the country.
Ooh. She wishes.
This is Crossroads, a bunch of crap. And their purveyor. Some people say he's full of it too, but I think he's a nice guy.
There you go.
Okay, this is a Sadowski jazz bass. I really love this bass. It's going to a friend of mine in Indianapolis. It's the 1993. Good bass. Well done, Mr. Sadowski. Guitar Show 94. Stingray table. My baby's not for sale. My graphite mats. Let's see what else we have today. G&L Climax, Alembic Stanley Clark, a G&L, one of about 40 made gold L1000. Bought that yesterday. Stuham Merge bass. Nothing to speak of. A clear plexiglass bass by Renaissance, Madeira, Zahn, Spectre, TVC, a new company, Sadowski, Warwick, from the Fender table, 62 reissue, 70 jazz bass, reissue, real 64, a beautiful blue sparkle piece of garbage, 62 reissue red. Let's go see whoever else has good basses. Yes, Scott already got the name for that. Let's see what he has. A couple of jazz basses. And a Stingray. That's kind of interesting. Let's see here. Somewhere over straight silver.
Dan. And how are you this fine day in Chicago?
I'm just fine. You like our weather?
I love it here.
Isn't it great? You want to move here? You know, if you sold your house in Marion, you could move into a nice two-room bungalow. This is a 51 key base. Going to Larry Briggs, I believe. The father of all electric bases. Pretty nice specimen. And then over here, probably one of the coolest key bases. A three-tone sunburst anodized guard, 59. Real nice bass. Silver tone, an electro. Mary Kay reissue key bass. I had one just like it. Very nice. Keybird bass. Autographed by, I think, the guy from Motley Crue. '65 jazz bass, matching headstock Olympic white, belonging to Don Anderson of St. Louis, one of my clients, I guess. Very nice. Looks yellow, but it is white. Olympic white. It is a Lefty Telly bass. Very cool. Just the red reissue, 62, matches the jazz bass. Nice basses here.
Partially.
Pardon me for Rick. Really nice one. Steinberger, Ken Smith, very nice Spectre, 24. This Spectre will hopefully be sold in about a half hour, but the way this business works. This is Chris Corfus, the Federa endorser, playing at Tobias Bass. He was not endorsed because of his playing ability, it's because of his natural good looks. Let's go around the horn and see what's been added. Randy, say hi to the camera. Bass player for Kathy Richards. What are the other guys?
Survivor.
Kevin Matthews?
Survivor Kevin Matthews.
All right.
Yes.
Mr. Ballard in five-string acquisition mode.
Five-string acquisition mode.
Oh, Mrs. Lake, and how are
you
today?
Don't say it. Don't. He does that every time.
Did you bring
Mrs. Lady? Did you bring
Okay, we can see by the time he's been here for 4 hours, and he's now playing the same bass he has at home.
Pretty solid.
Hello, Mrs. Lake, and how are you doing today?
We have sold virtually nothing, but we are having quite a good time. Take a gander around at all the folks. Let's see, it's kind of, I want to turn off that. This is it, number one. No, turn it off. Turn off that light. Turn that one off, too. Yeah, that's better. I think it's better. Looks better through here. There it is already. Just waiting for a little paint. This is our Zabs. We gotta check out that crummy wood too. Yeah. And here's the neck.
Ain't it a beauty?
Look at this. Look at this fine detail right here, will you, folks?
Zoom in. No battery.
Uh-oh.
Battery's up.
I like the way it works. It seems to, you know, it stiffens it up.
Well, that's a good shot with the light. Oh, shoot. Crudely kind of pan up from here. I want to look at it, but I need to just go.
You want the pickups in it?
No.
Level them out.
Are you rolling?
I'm rolling.
I'm rolling. Where's the only rule? Polishing.
Yeah, that's damn near the whole thing. Couple of knobs. Oh, I'm recording, and I was recording my hand.
Yeah, a couple knobs probably work.
Do you think we ought to go black in here?
And on the inside of there? I don't want to use water.
Some people do.
Well, yeah, I usually do, but I guess I could. On the production models, we will. Now, I'll stamp the serial in here again. And do you want to sign the body as well?
No. Well, you can always have the neck off again. Are you going to spray lacquer over it?
Over this?
Here we are. Once again, looking at an unfinished base.
Hey!
But we have frets today. And we got this lunatic.
Backplate.
Got a backplate. Where's our bridge?
Has anybody seen the bridge?
There's a bridge. All shiny.
Gotta buff it out, too.
I think there's enough clearance.
Cool.
There's the base getting the proper drying time.
Amazing. We're getting active.
He said he wanted our base. He was talking about all these other bases, but he definitely wanted ours there because it's a very intelligent design.
He's seen it, huh?
He's seen pictures of it. I mean, just drawings.
Very intelligent.
But he designed the electronics, so that's why he thinks it's intelligent.
Okay.
Spin it around. Ooh, it's so bright.
You'll notice our fine machining hole.
I think I can get in there and get that.
Right in there.
Yeah, it's pretty big. I can get in there no problem. Dun, dun. Dun, dun. Bum, 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 bum. First, he created Fender. Then he created Music Man. Then he died. And another couple guys created Lakeland.
What would Leo say?
He'd say, get me my lawyer.
It's a beautiful thing.
It's a beautiful bass.
Joint,
I got it there. I also got a little bird's eye right in the center of the neck. Where'd that baby? No. I mean the wood grain. I think that's why I think this one maybe. Yeah, I don't know. No?
Black base. Are we going to put a strap button on the headstock?
Yeah, sure. Leo hated rear mounted stuff. Leo's not here.
That's
Some pictures of Lakeman musical instruments. 1 week before the NAMM show, 1.5 weeks. Some wood, some quilts, some neck blanks, some tiger stripe. Cases all ready to go. This is exciting. This is Dan Lakeman bases, use bases. All part of the same thing. We're going to go see Hugh now.
Alright, you see it?
Thanks. It's going to get like a really cool angle.
Did you ever get rid of that hair in there?
It's in the viewfinder. It doesn't come out on the screen. Mr. Video Buff.
You got to take it apart.
Yeah, very good. You can put it back down. These are some other necks. Hugh, what's the next step?
Finish them.
Finish it.
Blend here. We got to blend over here.
You got a lot of blending to do, pal.
Blendacious.
You gotta get yourself some.
Here's the blended one.
And here's my fretless one. And I noticed some repair work needed to be done here by the last fret.
Where? What,
yeah?
It gets rounded over.
Oh.
Remember that cancel?
Oh, I don't know anything about them. Alright, and then the bodies, which we want to take a picture of here. We'll have more of those later. This is the semi-cherry burst. Get that out of there. Semi-cherry burst, which may be mine after the customer looks at it. Getting some pictures of the shop, Hugh, because this will not be the shop after first of the year.
New shop.
Yeah, let's see. Look at that. It's going to be so colorful over there, you know?
It's going to be. Yeah, we're going over to Dan's. Did you see these over here?
Look at this. From this to a finished neck in less than a week. Whoa, boy. Will miracles never cease? Hugh, I'll show this videotape of the shop to my dad after we move in and get the new one set up.
You think that might be a more proper way of doing it?
Oh, boy.
No, these were getting done by a guy that...
Here, let's see that one again, Hugh.
He paints for Hamer, and he used to paint for...
the big board. The big board.
Too much bowling last night.
He's got at least 2-3 more hours today to put in.
Oh, I got 7 or 8.
Let's see the shop. This is building number 1. I didn't get building number 2 with the finished base in it.
Oh, yeah. You want to get that?
Can you get it real quick?
Bartolones.
Wow. Here, hold it up. There.
It's got your Sony Wagman installed in the back side there.
Yeah. Cool.
Looks good.
Yeah, this is great. It's a nice rubber coating on the knobs, real stiff.
We call it the snot grip.
This is Lakeland Musical Instruments. This is a little messy today, but Dan has to work by this printer here. Dennis, if you could start something printing, usually can start it when I don't want it, but now when I want it, it takes a little time. Okay, so I'm on the phone over there. I got an important call. I have a famous artist on the phone who's looking for a bass guitar, and all of a sudden Dennis pushes a couple buttons, and in the meantime, we'll go around the room. Say hi, Stella. Stella's a big help with the guitars. Gary, big help. We may use him for shipping someday when we start shipping. Okay. And let's listen to this. Dennis runs over. Yeah, and he opens it up to check it out. Dan's on the phone. Thank you, Dennis. Let's go out and look at the rest of Lakeland Musical Instruments. Yeah, a box of masks. Let's go over to our spray area first, which is just getting started. This is a base that's slated to go to Rick Danko next Friday. That's 8 days. If it makes it, I'll be amazed. The better. Spray booth, a couple of necks. Amp that we test things out. Rack. Instruments close to completion.
Lights.
Hotties. There's Kevin repairing what he did wrong yesterday. Just kidding. Good worker. Ian working on a body. Hugh got a 12 o'clock appointment to deliver a bass. He's right on top of it though. You're all over it, aren't you?
Oh yeah.
Carl's desk, nicely clean. Neck. Neck back. Our new copy router. How exciting. This for the blend of the neck. Sell it to who?
Fishermen.
For what reason?
They smoke their fish with it.
With ash. And how much will they pay us? Will it be worth boxing it up in court and taking it over there?
Have them come and get it.
Okay.
Call them and ask them.
Greg Arzab's in the building, ladies and gentlemen. These are Joe Osborne's signature flat wounds.
Really?
It's
sure hard for me to tell anything about these. And it's laying right down on the neck.
Yeah, so that,
that's the way
I
he plays.
I haven't played that for years, so it's been definitely looking for him there, Mr. Baker.
Look at these jazz bass.
Second joke.
Take it back to Carl. Now, let me see the back of that. Hold it up. Hold it up.
Right here, man.
That's it.
Cheers, Carl.
Oh, yeah, there's it. Here's Paul Simon while Paul Simon's playing. There you go.
Paul Simon. I don't think Buddy Guy signed it.
He ain't that big. Famous Angus Thomas and the famous Hassan Khan. The dance team.
Silver. Silver. You're on Valerie in that one. Fifth Dimension CD is right by the bass. Looks good, doesn't it?
Is that mine?
Which one? It was yours.
Yeah, mine.
Is
that the one you wanted?
That's the one I was first jacking up, then we put Bartolini's on this one, and I sort of leaned towards the...
These are completely Fralin's on there.
Pickups, but I like that color of that.
Well, we can change it out for you.
We might have...
George, who are you? Who's we, George? What is we all about? George? What do you think I have to do to get my guy to put the decal on straight? That's the only one I had that was big.
It's the right shape and a heavy gauge. But this almost feels like tortoise shell. That's a little too hard.
Get more low end up into your particular foot thing.
Well, I don't know. Well, yeah, if it's a thin pick,
it gets more high end.
And you don't have anything pushing back, you know, it just slides off the string and this doesn't, you know. But if you do that with a thin pick, it's gonna go. And yeah, it's pretty thin.
Ready? Are we getting a double scale for this, or is this a single scale?
I don't know, I'll check it.
Okay, here goes.
Mm-hmm.
song, Joe.
We can live with the song. I tell you, man, the song tells you what to play.
But don't you got
to
play through the fade?
Pay attention. Drum, listen to what I just said and pay attention to that and remember it and don't ever forget it. The song tells you what to play. If you listen. You can play the melody, you can play the words, the lyric phrases and stuff. But don't just get it.
Okay, so we want to hear... we want to hear those strings on the other bass. I have the other bass ready to go without strings, so I'll switch those.
Yeah, so I think our question is sufficiently answered, though. You can nail the motherfucker.
Well, we'll find out which one will be exactly right.
Heavy this bass.
That could...
Yeah, are you going to change the neck? Is that
no, I'm just going to swap strings. I got to take on.
You got the other one ready, probably. I like that other one with those little strings, too. That felt good. So usually, what, the problem I have with little strings, if I hit it hard, they don't sustain. But those were doing okay with that. I don't know.
Is this Hal's car, or is that just him standing next to a car?
He had that old yellow Rolls Royce. Yeah, that was the same car. You remember the movie, Johnny? It's the same movie.
No.
Years and years ago.
Before my time.
Old movie.
Yeah.
But that car was in the movie anyway.
Oh, really?
How kind of put it in the story.
Wow.
It all knew Justin Rolls.
Right.
And I don't know what he did with it. But he drove that car in Jimmy Webb Way. He married Jim Cena's daughter.
Mm-hmm.
was you, though.
Is it me?
So, when you first started playing the Fender, it was all flat ones, right? All flat ones.
That's what came with it.
Right.
And then Labella put out a bunch of strings for different basses. They were all packaged the same, in a big package, like that big. And it had a list of basses on the front of the package, and the check mark by the name of the bass that those strings were made for. So I bought the one word Fender, and they were flat. I don't know if any of the other basses had round ones.
Because it's interesting how the tone, I mean, what was sort of standard changed to like the round wound tone, what Danny called more like a piano tone.
Yeah.
The tone of the flat wounds is more
upright.
Yes. Yeah, thuddier or something. And he was saying he thinks it's going to go back again.
Well, for a nice, pretty tone, I think you got pretty much have to have one for that slapping style, don't you?
Not necessarily, but yeah, I just chatter for it, yeah.
Oh, Joe, that's you, man.
See, I told him.
See?
He wouldn't listen to me.
You should see the way it sets off your eyes. Way back there.
In the right line?
You got to tune that. It's way up.